Hello guys, the most common use of VFD in industry nowadays is for power saving, apart from speed and torque control. This is because the motor is generally designed for a fixed speed. It is very difficult to get motor that runs at a desired speed according to your application. So generally a designer selects a motor a bit 10 to 20% higher for your requirement. This is why gearbox pulleys are placed in system so that you can get regulated speed. But in a process industry, the load requirement keeps vary from normal to peak. Now, designing motor on higher side causes the power to waste at normal or low load. This wastage of power can be recovered if a VFD is installed, so that power can be regulated and saved by running at a required speed according to your load application. However, it is not possible to save power by just installing a VFD on all kinds of loads. For that purpose, the load has to be identified. Torque speed curve is taken into consideration and saving is justified by return on VFD investment. Let us see what kinds of load applications are encountered in industry so that we can find the opportunities and explore possibility of power saving. First one is constant torque application. In this application, the starting torque is approximately equal to the motor rated torque and it all full speed, hardly a change is seen in torque requirement. For example, we have a positive displacement pump, reciprocating pumps, compressors, traction drives, conveyors, feeders, excavators, where torque is always in demand. Inertia of these equipment is so high that these equipment require high torque at all time from zero speed to full speed. So, scope for power saving cannot be justified here as far as payback is concerned. Moreover, these equipment used for process control. Second one is constant power load. These equipment requires high torque at the time of starting at low speed and low torque at high speed. So, power requirement remains constant from zero to full speed. The equipments are generally fall in this category are grinders, windings, winding machines, lathe machines. Here, the power saving scope is negligible due to constant power requirement irrespective of load or speed. Now, third one comes variable torque application. It requires very low torque at starting or at low speed and high torque at high speed. Now, third one comes variable torque application. It requires very low torque at starting or at low speed and high torque at high speed or full speed. Here, required torque is varied according to the square of speed and power varies according to the cube of speed. This category includes centrifugal, axle pumps, fans, blowers, many mixers and agitators. As speed is reduced in this equipment, the torque demand also decreases according to the square of speed and power demand also decreases according to the cube of speed. For example, if speed is reduced by 20%, then power comes down to the 50% level. Here is the cream. Power saving can be explored here in variable torque load application. These centrifugal equipment are used in industry for flow application of air, gas, liquid or water flow. When these centrifugal equipments are run at a rated full speed in process, they offer full flow, which is more than required sometimes. So, the flow is regulated with a damper or some control valve. Due to this, excess flow energy is wasted in the form of pressure drop across damper or valves. Better if these damper and valves are removed and flow is regulated by directly regulating the speed of a fan or pump or blower. A considerable power can be saved, which earlier was being wasted as a pressure drop. Now, how to program VFD for a variable torque? Because the torque of a motor is proportional to the ratio of voltage and frequency. So, we have to make it vary as per your requirement. So, while programming, VF control is selected and there is an option for VBF pattern selection. There, you will have to select the variable torque pattern or you can also customize VBF pattern as per your application requirement or need. This VBF pattern is nothing but a curve of ratio of voltage and frequency, which follows a particular motor. The VBF pattern indicates how much voltage across the motor or torque required at a particular frequency. You can also select the preset and customize it. Here in graph, you can see the lower frequency voltage is also kept low for lower torque requirement. Now, next step is VFD sizing or rating selection. When you go for selection of VFD, first of all, you should collect information about motor data and system plus this info. Type of flow, whether it is a constant or variable torque, speed range, control method or a special enclosure for panel. Here kind of load is variable torque type like pumps, blowers, fans. So generally the overload capacity of VFD should be kept 120% of FLC for 1 minute. And if this load is constant torque type like conveyors, positive displacement pump, compressors, then the overlock capacity of VFD should be 150% of FLC for 1 minute. It's better to specify VFD rating with overload current capacity rather than mentioning kilowatt or kilovolt ampere. Speed range, the motor should never run below 20% of rated speed. There will be issue of motor cooling. If you have to run below 20% speed, then you will have to arrange for auxiliary motor cooling system. The same for true when you are going to run motor over speed then rated. Confirm if motor design allows it. Panel enclosure. While selecting VFD and panel environment condition must be taken into consideration. There are few types of certification that drives are rated for IP protection, NEMA and UL type enclosure. So kindly specify. Now most important, inverter duty rated motors. A VFD does not create an exit sandwich due to PWM technique used in inverter. Rather, there is a square digital pulse output which puts additional stress on your winding and bearing. So wires used in today's motor can handle high voltage surges. But some additional features that an inverter rated motor should have is a separate fan particular for cooling purpose must be there if motor running at a low speed and particularly for constant torque application. Apart from that, grounding rings, isolated bearing to be considered for inverter duty motor while selecting a new VFD system. Now calculation of saving requires practical measurement of initial power when VFD is not there, when system being regulated with damper control valves, having pressure drop across it. Final power requirement is done after removing control valves and dampers. Now the difference of initial and final power is your actual saving achieved. Multiplying these saving can give a approximate payback time. So guys, how do you like this program? Kindly share and comment if you have any query. Lastly, do not forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you. Bye-bye.